So this is something you're not gonna see every day, even if you are just constantly in the horse trailer business. The technical name for this thing is an Adam J2040 Excursion, but that doesn't really mean very much. This is a completely custom crafted, crazy creation. They only build about two of them a year. It's for a very discerning, specific sort of client. Very upscale interior. Every feature on this just kind of through the roof. You can see that massive hay pod on the back there. I mean, it's absolutely enormous. And you can see the slope and curvature of this thing. This has a 9-foot interior ceiling. And there's a bunch of really interesting qualities on this one. But I think the thing that caught me immediately is that the living area, it's 18-foot short wall, by the way. This is a big sucker. I mean, we're dually country, by the way. But the living area is built backwards, and it seems wacky and goofy at first, but the more I wrap my head around it, the more I wish more living quarters were built this way. So over here in this carpetless slide, we have a hide-a-bed sleeper sofa, inner spring variety, that can open up into a guest bed if need be. But, you know, you're looking at it, you're like, yeah, but why did they do that? Why, though? Well, here's the thing. What if you have to pull over on the side of the road? You have to get in for something. It is much safer and easier to get to that side of the trailer, the driver's side of the trailer, versus the passenger side of the trailer. If you're on the side of the road, especially the big sucker like this, you're going to be glad that you have the door on that side. Now, what it allowed them to do in terms of laying out the interior here, everything is cool. I really like this. Now, that 9-foot ceiling, man, that is just something to behold. I have not seen a horse trailer personally built like this. This is a first for me. And I've been around Adam Trailers for over 10 years now. I've never seen one of these. Our sales manager has only ever seen one once before. Like I said, they only build a couple a year. And it's not that they're only willing to build a couple of the year. They try to make this a very exclusive thing. I'm always a sucker for bar stools. And there's tons of prep space around this thing. That is all solid surface countertop space. And that has more kitchen counter space, I think, than I have in my house. That's awesome. With plenty of easy reach outlets. We've got all hardwood cabinetry. It looks like maybe, I don't know if it's maple, but it's got like a maple sort of tone and pattern to it. I'm not an ace when it comes to, like, you know, trees or anything though. But anyway, I love how all the windows are fully framed out. And that is a sealed burner stovetop, a 4-burner stove at that. With just a truckload of cabinet space down below and above every little nook and cranny they could. This thing's clean too. I mean, I can't find problems with it. Floor is clean, ventless, easy cleaning. You've got a larger refrigerator over here, and that is dual source gas and electric. So if you are going to do some off-grid stuff, you're good to go. Central air, lights all over the place. I barely have any of the lights on right now. I'm just low on battery power. But I love how there's dual ducted air vents, and every single vent can close and turn. And the symmetry of this upper deck, I love this twin bed configuration. This is something I wish I saw more of in the horse trailer business. And, you know, like the Lakotas, the Adams, the Murhaus that we carry in the new horse trailer lineup today, I wish we had some more of this. This is just an absolutely cool arrangement. And those do look to be 80-inch long beds, if my eyes are not deceiving me. I'm not as good about figuring out twins. But the other thing here, what's cool about this is you can have your own separate mattresses. You can have different mattresses with different firmnesses. It's very different. It's very cool. And if we get right up under here, you can see that right above your, gooseneck bunk, you do have a larger vent fan for some awesome airflow. Now look at how deep that vent is. That's how much insulation you have in that attic. And I thought I'd get you right up close and personal with all that woodwork. Gosh, is that good looking. I like how it has a gleam without looking plasticky. You know, it doesn't look fake. It doesn't look cheap chintz. Now check this out. It's like a horse trailer that is like full-time capable. You've got a combo washer dryer over here. If you're going to go to extended weekend events or extended trips or something like that, this is fully long-term camp capable. And they, since it was 9 foot tall, they said, you know what? We have all this extra room now above that slide. Why don't we just put extra cabinet space there? They just really didn't waste an opportunity for anything. And whether you're upstairs in the kitchen or at the sofa, everyone gets a nice shot at the entertainment center over here. The layout of this thing is just stellar. So give you a good look at this combo-matic washer-dryer over here. That is a Splendide, which is like kind of the thing that you'd find very often put into the fifth wheels or motorhomes in the RV industry. That's just a little hanging rod. It's a collapsible hanging rod up here, so if you need a place to hang some stuff to dry out, or you just want some extra, a quick little prep hanger storage, you've got it. Just the way they framed out everything, like this pocket door here into the bathroom. Now, just like the living area, the bathroom is also built backwards, basically. And, I mean, I love it. I'm a fan. I like how this looks and feels. Of course, having an 18-foot short wall, they had tons, tons of room to really make this open. And this is the size of the bathroom I have in my house. I keep comparing it to my house because there's aspects of this that are like my house. It's awesome. Another of those larger vent fans for some superior airflow. And that does have a rain sensor all the way up there, by the way. Now, next to our bathroom vanity, oh my God, the hardware on this is, oh, that is nice. It just, everything, the latches and everything have such a buttery, smooth quality still about them. And I like that big stainless sink, but look how much room there is beside and behind it. You actually, you've got that appliance outlet in front, so if you need things like, you know, your blow dryers, your shavers or whatever, you got drawer space, cabinet space, you got all kinds of room, you got room for toothbrushes, and that is a deep vanity. Holy crap. Wow, that is big. Now check this out. It looks like you're an apartment door, like your neighbor's door, but it's just a walk-in closet. No big deal, right? This thing's obviously been very well maintained, not just inside, but outside. The skin looks great. That slide awning looks great. The main awning looks great. There's no oxidation or anything. Now up front here, there's actually like a metallic roll down garage style door to enclose this area. It is set for two propane tanks. I'm not exactly sure why there's only one, but you know, you are too capable. Now you've got dual individual leveling jacks. They're on their own switches, so that they're right up here, this equalizer system right there. So if you want to be able to level it side to side with those jacks, you can. Very awesome. When you never know what the driveway or the parking situation is going to look like at the next event that you're pulling into. That awning is power, and it's small, it's simple, but it's awesome. Just a little, I call it like a belly bar. It just gives you a place to set a drink or a meal. You could put some chairs out here, have a little place to set down a, you know, whatever you're drinking at that moment, or a plate of grub, you know, between events or rides or whatever the case may be. So it's a three horse. All of our stalls have drop down head windows. The rear two stalls have drop down rump side windows as well. Now this has an air ride suspension system also, so that your horses aren't getting all, you know, bounced around in there. And that's what we're looking at right here, an adjustable air ride. So if you want the trailer to handle a little stiffer, a little softer, you have the ability to kind of control that as you go. Now you see this ladder sticking down here. That leads us up to the largest hay pod I have ever seen. If I was a kid, we had this trailer back when I was doing 4-H and stuff, I'd have played hide and seek up here. You would have never found me. It might need cleaned up here a little bit, but I mean, you can obviously, it's aluminum. You can just spray the thing out. Who cares? No big deal. The gas struts are making it easy to get in and out of here. All the structures in place. My God, that is just a big old thing up here, isn't it? And I'm sitting on the, you know, safety rail right here. You've got a full walking deck. I mean, you got a cool little spot to have your own little, I don't know, put a chair and just kind of keep an eye on the neighbors and what's going on and all the people around you. Teleporting back down to ground level, splitting open those rear doors there. We've got a ramp over barn doors kind of arrangement here. This is a three horse, all aluminum, collapsible rear tack. You see those Adam and Blazon Saddle Boss saddle racks right there. Of course, all that again can be removed. Now up in here, the horse area, with this being wide enough, they were able to put mangers in. Now this trailer has definitely seen some use, but it's built like a Sherman tank. You know, you got a fully lined, insulated ceiling up here. Also, look at this. You've got a camera system for back here. You just need to get the little monitor to hold up in your vehicle. And all three stalls have a full-on like LED light that runs the entire length of that thing, and fans for the animals to get some superior airflow in here. Simple, easy, one-hand latches, meaning you can keep a hand on your animal, which is safer for horse and rider, of course. And you can see how you have that front stud curtain there. Now, because you can latch that barn door open, they didn't want the last stall's window to drop down and like accidentally bash into that. So the front two stalls have drop-down rump windows. I think I phrased that incorrectly earlier, but there's the correction for you. This is something different. This isn't something you're gonna see every day. I've been doing this for 10 years. I've never seen one like this before. It's not gonna be for everybody. It's gonna be for a very discerning person. This thing brand new is like $140,000 to $160,000. It's a complete tip to tail, one-off custom engineered trailer. That's awesome. That is just one bad animal right there. So if you like what you see, give us a call here at Halet RV Brokers. We'll get you on the trails. Although, I mean, this thing, you're going to have to find a place to park it, maybe before you hit the trails. But that's the whole point of the horses, right? To go hit the trails. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.